Hello everyone. So we were solving CM1 September 2019 paper in the Word. The first two questions were theoretical questions and we were in the question number 3. We have completely solved question number 3 in Word as to how we can write this in Word. This we did in our last class. Moving on, the fourth question, the fourth answer is also a pure theoretical one in which you just have to type down all of these using bullet points. The bullet points you will get in the home tab. So let me just show you all. In the home tab, this in the paragraph section, you have different bullet points in which you can easily use these bullet points which you have over here, or the numerical ones. So these were the bullet points. From here you can easily type down your answer. The next is question number 5. So question number 5, we have certain numericals to it. The very first equation which you see is P into A du x is equal to AX. Now here A du x can be, I have written down this in the bold, as you can see, this is P. And for multiplication, I have used star as per the notations given by the IFOA. So if you do not have that particular document, I will attach this to the description box below. We have A du x and then colon x. So for the age over here, you have to give a colon. A du stands for this A du, and then give a colon x. This is equal to the whole life factor, assurance factor over here. But in the notations given by the IFOA, there is no notation given for the whole life. So we'll just take it to be as AX. It seems exactly similar to this, or you could have written this using the mathematical typing or the equation editor, which we say. So I'll just show you all how to do that. Alt equal to will give me the equation editor. So I will first write down P, capital P, and then for equal multiplication sign, I will write backslash times. And then for the A, I'll go into the structures, and in this we have this accent. So I'll choose the second one. Click on the left arrow to move within. Click on the left arrow to move within the box and type in A underscore X and give a space, and it gives you A du X, right? Click on the right arrow, move out of it, equal to, and then for AX, again capital A underscore X under space. So this is how you can write it down if you are using the mathematical or the equation editor. Here this I have done with the use of notations as given by the IFOA. The second one is a prospective reserve at time t. For that we write tvx and p we have as a superscript. So for that, what I have written as per given by the notations given by the IFOA, you can write TV and for P, which is there. So this P is not V to the power P. This is not, you need to understand the difference between V to the power P and V as a, and this P as a superscript, because this P here refers to the prospective. This P here refers to the prospective reserve. So you need to write it within the brackets, within the first brackets. P and then again colon X for the age. Again we have A here. So we do not have any, again we do not have anything for the whole life given by the IFO. So I've just simply written AX plus T. You can do this. You can just simply give a colon over here and you can simply write it down. Or you can do it without the colon itself, because this seems understandable. If not, you can give a colon and just simply give this within the brackets. And then simply give this within the brackets, right? So this seems AX plus T as the whole life. Minus P multiplied by, because when I am not using the equation editor, then I will not use this times, right? I will simply use the star as the multiplication. Remember that when you are using the multiplication, when you are using the equation editor, then you will have to use the times, backslash times shortcut. Otherwise you can use the star sign. Again we have A du colon x plus t is the age. So this is how I've written the prospective reserve. You can again use the equation editor and you can write this TV XP, which I have explained in my previous video how we can do this. We can do this in the structures we have. So let me just show you all this very first thing and then we'll move on to the next one. In the structures, in this section we'll use this one, the left superscript and subscript, where here I will type V, capital V, in here I will type an X. In top I do not need anything, I'll just give a space. So here I'll give a caret sign, P underscore X and space. So this is how you can write using the equation editor, and the rest I have showed you all. Right, moving on, then we have this entirely solved equation over here. So we have the very first one is the retrospective reserve at time t, which I tried writing using the notations and not using the equation editor. So we have 1 plus I, this is 2 the power t, remember this is 2 the power t, and this is not as a superscript. So I've used this caret sign. This is a very important difference which you need to make when you're using the notations. This P stands for a superscript, whereas when you give this caret sign, this represents, okay, this is 2 the power t divided by tpx, and then there will be one more bracket over here. So this entire thing forms a bracket. Then we have multiplication for that star I've used, and then it goes in the similar manner as you can see. But I'll explain you all. It says P into A du X colon. Now this T is the duration. This T is the duration. So for that, this is basically the this sign gives you A du, as you have seen earlier, where I just wrote A du X. So A du X was in this form, A du colon X, X is for the age. Similarly, you write A du, let me give a space over here, A du X, this is for the age, X is for the age, then for the duration, you again give a colon and you write the duration within these brackets, within the less than and greater than brackets, because this will be meant as and will be taken as the duration as given by the IFOA notations. Here we have the term assurance, not the whole life. So we'll, according to the notations given by the IFOA, we'll write TA, meaning term assurance. Again, the age is X and colon, we'll give a T. Now this also you can do it within the equation editor. I will show you all how to do this particular portion, but then again it becomes difficult because the duration will not be specifically written in case of the equation editor. So I think writing this with the use of notations will be easier, will be more faster than by using an equation editor, because you'll not be able to write this T within the bracket which we use on top, as the duration will be not easier to write in case of equation editor. So this seems really reasonable solution for this, because we have term assurance, and for this also we have the entire thing which is given by the IFOA notations formula, which was given by the issued by the IFOA. So this is how we write this particular equation. Right, moving on, I will solve this entirely, not entirely, but I will solve some parts of it. So in my second part, let me just start solving. So we have T. What I can do is, instead of again writing it down, it's always better to copy the previous one. So let me just copy down this entire equation and paste it over here. So this is exactly similar to what you see, right? Again, you can put x plus t within the brackets, but then that doesn't matter much because it will be read as x plus t as the age, right? So then we have equal to, the same thing is there. So I will try to copy and paste wherever you can, because that will save a lot of time. So I'll just copy this and paste it over here. Minus p, again a multiplication. Now this lx by lx plus t is also given by the IFOA notations, so we'll use the same. I'll write capital L. You can give it within the brackets also if you want to, otherwise you can avoid it, doesn't matter. Capital lx divided by capital lx plus t. Then again we have, so let me just use the bracket, so I think that will be better in here. So then we have again a multiplication and one plus I to the power t multiplied by, then again we have this then we have this t slash a du x. Now this is also given by the IFOA, so in the notation, so I'll just simply use the same over here, a du and x, right, minus p for premium multiplied by, again I'll copy this down, this entire thing is there, right? So let me just copy paste wherever I can. This entire thing can be copied. So whenever you move to the next line, make sure that this multiplication sign which you have, or maybe it is a plus sign or a minus sign, this should end in the first line, and when you move to the next line you move with this. If you move with a multiplication sign in the next line, then it becomes difficult to understand whether the equation has been stopped over here and you're starting with a new equation, or it's continuing. So generally it's a typing you can say norm which we follow, is that we end it with a minus or a plus sign so that we know that it is continuing below, right? So let me just divide these and let me just put minus over here and move to the next line. So here we are, and then again we have, now I'll show you all how to write this. It's very simple. We have done this a du, again I give a colon, x, and again I give a colon, and for duration I mention it within these brackets which you see. Again we have a plus premium, and so I can copy this entire thing down because this is again the same, so I can copy and paste it. I have already copied and pasted it over here. Then we have after this multiplied by this entire thing again, so I will copy this and paste it over here, right? This is how I have written the first line for you all. The next line is also in the same way. I don't see any new notation over here. So we have written how to, we have seen how to do all of these. It's exactly in the same similar manner. I do not see any new notations over here. So I would leave this up to you all for practice. Make sure if this entire question is of 4 marks, so this second part was of 4 marks, it should not take more than 4 minutes for you all, 4 to 5 minutes for you all to type this entire thing down. Maybe it should take less than 4 minutes to type this entire, because this is a formula which is, this is a proof which you all should know beforehand, and for typing it should not take more than 4 minutes. So with practice you will improve it, and you need to understand where to do copy and pasting, because that's very important. You can just simply copy and paste your answers. You do not have to write same notations again and again, again and again. You see, there is a lot of time where p into lx by lx plus t is repeating. There is a lot of time where a du xt is repeating. So all of these can be copied and pasted again and again. I've written down this in the bold for you all to understand. You do not have to write this in bold in your exam scripts. So this is how we solve the fourth question. Moving on, this was the fifth question, sorry. Moving on to the sixth question over here. In the sixth question, there is no such sort of mathematical typing. It's very simple. So I have already written down over here for you all. As you all can see, we have V1, which is 1 by 1.04. So I can write this by simply V and in brackets 1 equal to 1 by 1.04 can be simply written down. So this can be simply, and then when you move to the next line, you do not have to write this again. What you can do is you can just simply copy this entire thing. I'll show you all. Copy this entire thing and paste it over here, and then simply change the things which are different, right? So 1.04 multiplied by 1.05, and you can change the number. So this is how you will save time. Do not keep on writing same thing. Similarly for V3, you copy it from V2. Similarly from V4, you copy it down from V3 by just changing the number here. One number here, adding on this, and then changing the number, final number here. So this is how you can save your time even without writing it again and again, as I showed in this question. Again, this was a simple plain question thing to write. So you can simply copy V1 again and then paste it continuously by just changing this 2, 3 and 4 instead of typing it down, plus 100 V4, and then the answer is there. Again, this part is very easy. So I have already written it down for you all. We are equating this 94.9342 to 4A4. Now this again can be written as 4, and here this can normally be written as 4A, and then as this is a duration and not an age, this is a CT1 question, so there is no age. What you can do is you can write 4A and then give a colon and then write N within these brackets so that it is read as a duration. Remember, these are the notations which are given by the IFOA. So two things which you need to keep in mind as that in this class, which I have explained, is that there is a difference between a superscript and a par. When you give a superscript, you write it within the first brackets, and when it is in par, you use a caret sign. This is how you use the superscript V4. This explanation I think is very simple for you all to understand, which I've already typed, and this can also be written as a using the equation editor, but I have written down simply by using the forward slash and in a linear manner instead of using a mathematical equation or editor in this. Moving on, in the seventh question we have certain equations to write, so I'll just explain you all. We have P given as the annual premium, and then we can write this as P, capital P. Then I'm using notation, so I can just simply use multiplication as given by the IFOA. Now here we have 4% on the top, so what you can do instead of writing on top, you can complete this entire line and write by giving a comma at the side, that solving at 4% rate, solving all at 4% rate. So that can also be done. I'll show you all how to do that. A due colon 45 for age, again a colon, and then within these brackets I will write 20 equal to we have 20,000, so we have 20,000 minus 2,000 multiplied by, again we do not have anything for whole life, so I'll just simply prefer using A colon 45, and then we have plus 2,000 into, then here is the thing which I wanted to show you all, which is again you can write this as A45 or A colon. I think A colon 45 will be more desired one to use. Then we have increasing assurance. Now how to use this, how to write this, this is also given by the IFOA, but in case of IFOA they have given it only for the term assurance, so I can simply use IA colon and then 45 for increasing assurance. This can be done. Otherwise, what you could do is leave this for the time being, because we have mailed to IFOA regarding these notations which are not there in the prescribed notations given by the IFOA. So we can wait for the mail. Otherwise, I think this is a preferred way to write, because this seems reasonable. For term increasing term endowment, they have shown it this way. I'll just show you all increasing. So I for increasing and then bracket term assurance, and then they have given the age as X and then again the duration in this way. So this is the increasing term assurance factor. This is the notation for increasing assurance, which they haven't mentioned. So we are time being going in this particular manner, and if there is any changes, that will be notified in the further videos. In here, after giving the comma, you can just simply write solving at 4% interest rate. Right, so this can be easily done instead of mentioning 4% again and again. Again, this being very simple, I'm not going into this again. So here we have no new equations. Here we have 17b, that can again be written as simply 17 and then a capital V. So that can be done with you all, or you can just simply write, or you all can just simply write V and 17. Because here we have mentioned the time, so we can simply write V and then give the entire formula. That can also be done. This is A due colon 62 colon in that brackets, duration brackets 3. Again, we write A due colon IA colon 62 as I have written over here. So again, there is no new equation which I see. Any new equation which I see in question number 7, but what I have done over here is this particular equation which I have written. This is not mentioned by the IFOA in their notations section. If you are using notations, you can go through this manner, or if you want to use equation editor for this, so that can also be done. I'll show you all how you can use equation editor for this. So alt equal to, and in the equation editor I will just write brackets IA capital IA and then obviously underscore 45. So this is how you can write this IA 45. It does not take much time in equation editor, or if you want to go in this manner, make sure you are using only one way of practice. If you are using both the ways, then you will be confused in the exam as to which one to use. So make sure you are using only one way when you are practicing. Either you are following the equation editor one, or you are using the notations. Sometimes equation editor proves more efficient and it consumes less of a time in case of using notations. So I would suggest that in those cases only you can use the equation editor. Otherwise, try using and going with the simple notations given by the IFOA. So do not see any extra. Q61 can simply be written in this manner, which is Q and 61 over here. So this should be a Q 60. So I'll show you all here. Q and 61. This should be a small Q. So this is how you can write. This is also given in the IFOA notations as to how you can write Q61. If it's 2Q61, suppose if it's 2Q61, then simply 2Q61, right? This is how you use the notations. Moving on to the 8th question. This I will cover in my second video from the question 8 onwards. So for the time being, try practicing till question number 7. The new notations which I introduced was this duration one, how to write it within these brackets, and I explained the difference between a superscript and something to the power, right? So try practicing, and this Word document will be attached in the डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स बिलो. थैंक यू सो मच.